In today's fast-paced world, we hardly find any time to go out and visit a temple nearby, but we always desire for it, more so if there is a temple or a place of worship which is of mythological or historical importance, but due to lack of information, we miss them out. So today we have decided to go to one such temple that if you live in Bangalore, I'm very much sure that you would have visited Mysore many a times and you should have crossed Channapatna. Both Mysore and Channapatna are so famous. Mysore is one of the famous tourist cities in India and Channapatna is famous for wooden toys. But today, I will be taking you to the very important Channapatna temple known as Shri Navaneetha Krishna Temple, Channapatna, also known as Ambegalu Krishna Temple, Channapatna. Shri Navaneetha Krishna Temple is a beautiful and ancient temple situated on Bangalore-Mysore highway and is around 60 kilometers from Bangalore. The place is called as Channapatna and that temple where we are going is around 3 kilometers from Channapatna city center and the village is called as Dodamallur. If you are traveling from Bangalore, take Bangalore-Mysore highway. After around 55 kilometers, you will reach Channapatna, famous for wooden toys. If you plan to travel by rail, Channapatna is the nearest railway station here and the nearest airport is Bangalore only. Nearby cities to visit Channapatna, Bangalore, Srirangapatna and Mysore. There is an interesting legend about the origin of the name Mallur. Many years ago, a king known as Sarangadhara had his hands cut off in a war with his enemies and was thrown into the Nirmala River, now known as Kanwa River, flowing nearby. In spite of severe pain and weakness, he managed to reach this temple and worship the Lord with all his heart. Pleased with his devotion, the Lord blessed him and the king got back his hands. Based on the word Mulethu, meaning grew back, the place seems to have got its name Mulethur, which was later shortened by usage of Mallur. We are passing through a well-sculpted and beautifully decorated archway by the roadside to reach the temple complex. We left Bangalore at 7 a.m. and reached the temple by 8:30 a.m. over the Mysore National Highway. We need to shell out rupees 10 for parking and entered the main entrance, Gopuram. Very soon we were greeted with very old stone doors and pillars adorned with Dashavatara and Lord Krishna's childhood scriptures. The shrine is towering and the majestic Rajagopuram greets us at the entrance. The magnificent structure built in the Dravidian architectural style is embedded with statues of Lord Vishnu in different manifestations of his Das Avatara. The Dodamallur Shrine is also known as Dakshina Ayodhya based on the legend that Lord Rama had stayed here for a while during his exile. According to the annals of history, this temple complex was built in the 4th century by Chola Emperor Rajendra around the original sanctums where the idols already existed. It is surprising to learn that the whole temple complex is built on sand and does not have any solid base or foundation. Legend has it that great sages like Kapila and Kanva stayed here and worshipped Lord Aparamaya in various yugas. This temple is dedicated to Lord Aparamaya, Arvindavalli and Lord Krishna, also known as Ambegalu. This abode of Ambegalu Navaneetha Krishna is situated at Dodamallur, a small hamlet about 68 kilometers from Bangalore off the Bangalore-Mysore highway. The tall Rajagopuram of this shrine is clearly visible from the highway about 2 kilometers beyond Channapatna. In this Kshetram, it is said that the childless couple who pray to Ambegalu Krishna will be blessed with a baby. This is a Divya Kshetram and Punya Bhumi. This main entrance or Mahadwara is 30 feet in height and as we enter, we see a small statue of Mahishasurmardini on our left and Lord Krishna on the right. A tall monolithic Dhvaja Stambh is placed just in front of the doorway. Once inside the Parikrama enclosed compound, there is the Moola Murthy, main deity of Lord Vishnu in the form of Shri Aparamaya. The tall, magnificent idol is made of Shaligram stone. As we walk through the Parikrama towards the left of the main sanctum, we reach the small shrine of Goddess Mahalakshmi, known here as Arvindavalli due to the belief that she was born in a lotus flower in Vishnu Tirtha. The idol of Chaturbhuja Devi is seated in Padmasana posture on a lotus.
We continued our pradikshina and reached the northwestern corner of the parikrama. Here we can see Ambegalu Navanitha Krishna. Ambegalu means crawling on all fours. The adorable child Krishna is in a crawling posture atop a flat Garuda Pitham. It is believed to be one of the very rare Krishna shrines where he is in the form of a toddler. The beautiful idol is made of shiny black stone and is believed to have been installed by Veda Vyas himself. The baby is holding a ball of butter, Navanita, in his right hand and appears to be moving towards us. It is known that couples offer silver and wooden cradles at this shrine to be blessed with children. Janamashtami is the most important festival at this shrine, when thousands of devotees throng to worship and seek Navanita Krishna's blessing. It is said that worshipping Lord Krishna here mitigates putra dosha, and hence lot of people come here to pray for their kids. This temple is open between 7:30 a.m. to 12 p.m. in the morning and between 5:30 p.m. to 8:30 p.m. at evening. Overall, a very nice place to visit with family and friends. Do visit this place and share your visit experiences with us. If you have not subscribed our channel yet, please do subscribe and hit the bell icon button to get the latest video updates. Thank you so much for your time.